Hi everyone, welcome to Calico Critter World. Today I'm going to show you how to make the structures that I put in my little world, and we're going to use some very simple items. Most of it's Dollar Tree, and I'm going to show you what I do, and I'm going to also show you the measurements that I have, which I will also put down in the description box, and the reason why I chose those measurements for the structures. Let's get started. Okay, so here is the boutique. And I'm gonna take all of the items out of here. So here's the boutique, and it's just made out of this board, this foam board. So it's nice and thick. It's got the foam inside, and you can get this at the Dollar Tree for $1.25. You get quite a large piece. One piece should probably do a building, depending on what size you want your building. So I think the most important thing when building these is to decide what size you want. Too big, it'll be hard to display. Too small, it won't be enough room for a diorama, or it won't be enough room for everything that you want to put inside. Find how big I wanted it. So here's how big I have it. So I have it 12 inches wide. And I have it 9 inches deep, or to the back, right? So all of my buildings then measure this, with the exception of the house. And I only have two buildings at this time. As you know, I have the boutique and I have the bistro. Then I have the house, which I made a little bit bigger and wider, and that was because I needed to accommodate the furniture that I bought, because it's not Calico Critter furniture. It's 1/12 scale dollhouse furniture, and the couches were pretty beefy, and so they needed more room, and I knew that, so I made the house a little bit bigger. But the house does stack on top of these buildings. And I can stack all three buildings on top of each other if I want to do like a tower scenario and put some railings on the side and whatnot for like an outdoor walkway. And so that is what I did. So in deciding whether you want to do this size or not, please keep in mind that you, like I said, you can stack them. So if you don't have a lot of room in your house or your bedroom or wherever you're going to display your Calico Critter Town, making your own is the greatest option of all, because you can make these little railing pieces and they can fit here on the sides, so that gives you the ability to stack the buildings and still have scenery going on. So I can put my bistro on top of this building, and I can have this little walkway here to display the Calico Critters on, and I can also put little tables and chairs out here from the bistro so they can be eating and walking, and I can have more of a diorama. I expand the diorama without expanding the width or the bulk of the diorama by going upward, much like with Calico Critters original buildings, that you stack them and collect them and put them together. So that was my idea behind that. And this railing and additional piece is also made out of the poster board, and then I just cut and glued on these little dowels that also come from the Dollar Tree. On the bottom, I did the bottom in sandpaper. And I did the top just regular colored paper, construction paper from the store. and I hot glued all the rails on, and they're super. Is 9 inches, so I'm going to cut it back, and I want the bakery to come to here. So I'm going to make the bakery 5 inches in depth and 12 inches in length. So we start with our poster board. Okay, so we're gonna make a cut here. Going to be 5 by 12, and then you want to use a metal, if you have a metal ruler, I think it's best to cut. Plastic one if you don't have a metal one, but metal's better. It'll protect your fingers a little bit better. And then you want a really sharp tool.